you see, this is my laptop here, and there's a gaffer tape here, and people think, yeah, it's because you don't want to have the Apple logo on it somehow, which it's not, because the thing is that when you're working in theater, everybody has a laptop, and then you know, if you're an actor, you see like 30 Apples out in the auditorium. It's just for that, so, but it's funny. Yeah. I have a lot of these books, you know, which, one of the things I learned really early on is I always have like a book on me and a pencil. It just becomes a thing you do. It's just with, you know, having your house keys with you when you go out. It's the same thing. Yeah, I mean, you need a book and you need a pencil. You know, this is like, I like this book. It's a bit cool. It's, you know, it's not like a, yeah, it's a cool book from this store called Muji. The Japanese make really cool books. And then this is the pencil I've started using now. It's the Palomino Blackwing, which is supposed to be the best pencil in the world, but, you know, some hipster guy just decided that. But it's a really, really good pencil. And once you've used a Palomino Blackwing, you'll never use anything else. And you see, it's almost like this is a special edition of that most special pencil. They're normally just black, but this one has like, it's called the Fender Stratocaster. It's a special edition because, yeah, it's supposed to, you know, emulate kind of how they paint Fender Stratocasters, I think, which is totally, I mean, you can use any pencil you want. It doesn't really matter, but, you know, it becomes just a question of being cool, stuff like that. And as I was saying, I have a lot of writer friends that have a lot of these books, like me. But you'll only have like 2 or 3 pages there, some bullshit, then maybe 20 pages of nothing, and then there's something. So I have like a full, yeah, I have boxes filled with these, and then maybe once a year I'll go through them and burn them or something. I'll have to remember to do that before I die, to burn them. My name is Jón Atli Jónasson. I'm a screenwriter and playwright from Reykjavik, Iceland, living in Berlin, Germany. I started writing in 2001, where I kind of got a chance to write a short story compilation. And then in 2003, I had 2 productions made. I won like a theater competition in Reykjavik, Iceland, and that was the start of me working in theater. And my mother is an actress, so theater wasn't really a place I didn't know. I'd read a lot of scripts and, you know, was in the back wings of theaters since I was a kid. The writing work is just, you have to somehow just show up for work and be patient. And, you know, if stuff comes, you just have to grab a pen and a paper. That's it, basically. And not get in the way somehow. You know, working in theater a lot and in film, it feels a lot more like physical work than me sitting alone in some room writing something all day, which is sometimes the truth. I mean, I will write film scripts where I spend most of my time alone and maybe a little bit on Skype or on the phone with somebody. But yeah, it's, you know, in many ways, like a lonely profession. So, but when you're doing projects, you know, as I say, in the theater or film, I mean, I'm always super grateful that I just get the contact with other people, just in terms of exchanging ideas and finding stuff out. So then it's more of a team sport somehow.
Hvað varstu lengi í sjónum?
Nokkra klukkutíma, kannski 6.
6 klukkutíma.
After working, yeah, for the last 10 years on like relatively, yeah, big budget films in terms of Scandinavian films, and having been a part of The Deep, writing the screenplay and seeing that film being made. It was a really, really big film in terms of Icelandic film, very expensive and complicated shoot. I wanted to do something low budget and a bit different, so I had heard about this, this crime story in the paper about this young man who goes home after, you know, going out on the town to a nightclub with a girl who is a former girlfriend of a small-time criminal. And this small-time criminal, he hears about them sleeping together and decides to kidnap the young man and extort him for money. And this is a true story. And I just found it interesting, this story, also very horrible, and wanted to kind of go and do a true life version. I think that's the word of it, just what happened, the scenario and everything. And we just kind of sat down and we didn't like really make a detailed script of it, because I was more interested in seeing, okay, now we have a scene here where two guys come and try to extort money from this one guy, and the scene ends with them taking the guy with them in a car. What came out of that was there's not a lot of talking in the film. There's almost no dialogue. The only dialogue you kind of hear is come here, sit down, shut up, give me a cigarette, start the car, stuff like that. So that became the dialogue of the film, which I thought was good, because my problem with crime films is always when you have these kids talking like gangsters. And it wasn't to my taste. I don't know if it's real or not, but I just wanted to do like a film that was more about the actions and less about the talking. My next project is a film called Imagine Murder, which tells the true story of a group of teenagers in Iceland in the 70s that are arrested and accused of murdering two men who have nothing in common and have gone missing in Iceland. And the story tells their experience. They are held in solitary confinement for a really, really long time, up to 2 years for some of them. And their will is just breaking down, and their character, and they are forced to kind of come up with a scenario in terms of how they killed these men, which they never met, according to them. And in the film, we investigate not only the disappearance of these two men and their possible murder, but also the big crime, which is the mistreatment of these young teenagers from the local police force. Inspiration comes from everywhere. It can come from the most unlikely places. What gets on my nerves is when I am disorganized, which is, you know, I am a chaotic person, so I'm always a bit annoyed by that. I could be more organized, I think.